is pull them tighter like this mm-hmm. and hold it there, bowling. Or even bend it a little bit to make it bowl. You see, then it'll start going up. Yeah. And that'll pull those down too. So these here, you just pull over together and pull it tight. Zittle. And shape it up.
Because it's got a big gap in the sides right in there, and it keeps going in there like that.
And this basket is a fine, fine weave, probably about 60 years old. How thin these are. And that's what we were talking about, how Mom was thinning them down a while ago. 13 stitches per inch. And that's what the collectors are looking at, those stitches. They have people like on this basket here, holding hands all the way around the basket, and that's called a spring ceremony. And this is the white root, the black root, and the red bud. White root, hopwood.
Hopwood.
Black root. Yeah, I forgot black root.
Not that.
Red bud.
An up.
Yeah. And then in the middle, the thing that's in the middle of all of this that we weave around is called the deer grass. And in our language, it's chuckish. And that's a big, hard process to go out and gather. And that's seasonal. I hope everybody's got their fill. Did you get some? Not yet. I'm gonna head back. But I always see them on the way, so I still clip. But my hand's getting full. If you are going to be a basket weaver, you need to get out here and pick.
Yeah, this room, my mom and them used to come out and gather a lot of these. And the lady that owns it, I think her her mother used to weave.
What we're looking for is the darker brown sticks on here. Instead of the dried out ones, these are the newer sticks on here. So that's what we try to look for. And we're trying to get the straightest ones. These are a little bent, but we need to get the straighter ones for this. But when we clean them, you can straighten them out. We tie it with yarn, and it can straighten them out, the bent ones on there, so that it'll be good.
This is, well, I used to do it with my grandma when I was little, but haven't been out here since. It's like 8, 9 years old. So, familiar with it, just haven't done it in a while.
You have to really look in the bushes here because there's a lot of straight ones in there. You just have to look.
I got some more too, I think, Mom. The more the merrier.
There's a lot of good ones going to be here pretty soon. I'll just leave it till next time. They'll be bigger. I have to get out of this jungle.
The European days, I try not to think about it because that's all in the past. But I know when my kids see the documentaries, you know, it makes them very angry. And I know we have things to be angry about, but it's not going to help anything, you know. So we just, I don't know. I just try to educate people on what we're doing and why we're doing it now, and you know, just trying to keep the togetherness and getting our traditions to come back and stay alive.
I'm picky.
I mean, you see how many different tribes that it's brought together today. And this is Monos, Tatchus, Chumnees. And then Donnie's looking for milkweed that we make our belts with.
great-grandmother had just the fiber itself, and then when if she got ready, she'd just lay it out there and grab a few strands each and then just roll it on her leg and then start weaving. See, it's these. This is the fiber that we peel off of these, get all that little covering off of it, and then kind of roll this up into a little string. They'd make long strings and about three or four of them, and then braid it into a belt, or yeah, belt-like with a rope.
This is the peppermint tree, and it's a medicine. Mash it up, and you can boil it.
And you can smell it.
It smells fresh.
Yes, peppermint.
Put the leaves on where you ache. Good for aches and pains.
Grandmother would pick acorn, prepare acorn, pick wild onions, pick mushrooms, pick sawberries, and all the nature that was around us. Never went shopping. Everything was made, prepared at home. Oh, as I grew up, air was good, water was good, clear and cold. Well, we moved to the valley. They were farm labor, so when the season finished, we'd come back home. And after they passed, then we just stayed in the valley. Most of us, like myself, we went to school, so we got away from the Indian way of life and the language, so we're going back into that too. And my grandmother, she talked Tachi, no English, so therefore you had no choice but to learn it. So I learned it then. And now we're looking for someone to speak it, so I know a little bit, so I'm helping my family.
See that green out there? Those little bunches? That's the watercress that we eat.
These are good with salad. I like to eat them with lemon and onions and soy sauce. Mmm. I think I got plenty.
Right here. Oh, where? You can't make it right here?
Oh,
my willow.
Okay, come on up, Chris.
We're at Mom's house that she's lived here for 40, 50 years. And today I'm going to be teaching Rachel, Dave, and Andy how to make a baby rattle. And these are not our traditional rattles, but it's used with our traditional materials. Take 5 sticks and 4 sticks and crisscross them. Do 2 ends, flip 2 ends over so you got 2 fat ones and 2 skinny ones like this. Alternate. Okay. Down. And then up that way. That, yeah, crisscross those. And pull this in over this way. We never lived on the reservation, and we were always out here working in the fields, picking oranges, lemons, tomatoes, olives.
Keep them together, right?
Just all the fruit.
Grapes.
Grapes, oh gosh.
We're just kind of like making the X.
I got into baskets because our grandma did baskets, and she'd sit out there on her little olive box and her little pillow, and she'd weave all day long.
Over and under and pull it down.
And I really wanted to keep making baskets because I knew it had to be in me somewhere to know how to learn how to do these because my grandmas all did them.
Okay, this is a hole root. And we have to split it. I usually do these with my teeth, but a lot of the ladies don't like to use their teeth. So,
let's see, and it's really hard to do these to get them pliable. You have to shave it. You can feel it here. It's really kind of stiff and thick. So we try to shave it, that excess, but you still need that white on there.
So you have to hold your thumb right here so it sort of guides your thickness.
This basket here is one that I've been working on for probably 3 years. I started it so I was going probably the next year. I quit about here, and then the next year I thought, well, I'm gonna keep going. So I started getting it too big right here. And so I saw that that's not the way it's supposed to be. So starting right here is where I realized this is how a basket is supposed to be done, you know, stitch by stitch. And then I use small weavers here where it, see how small those are in comparison to this. So this is basically my learning basket. And so I said I wanted to make that for my mom because she loved her grandma so much. Since I'm using red bud, I like to see the color. Might as well show what you got, huh, Ma? One, two, three, four. All these grooves right here, all the way around, to see how many sets you could get and to match up to, you know, so you're not having two together. And did we tell you our rules? Oh, do you remember them all? Or do you have it?
Always make an offering when we gather any of our basket trees. We pray to the Creator. Tell Him we're here to gather our basket material and to give us a good crop for next year. And we don't take any more than we can use.
This one too, or is it too curvy?
That's okay. Yeah, those are pretty.
I like that one.
Yeah. Get him, get him.
Straight and good. Uh-huh.
Oh, you have to give your first project away.
Oh, yes.
And that's to teach them to give. Mm-hmm. You know, you love something you make. You don't want to give it away, but it's your first project, so you have to learn how to give by giving your first project to somebody. And just pull it like that.
And the reason we don't weave at night is because the belief was that the spirits, the bad spirits, travel at night and it might get into your basket. And that's also why we don't weave when we're angry or sad, because all that stuff goes into your basket. That's why the basket does what it wants to do a lot of times.
And the baskets, I know for sure, you know, that our people used them for cooking and for their seeds and for making the acorn. Our baskets were used. This one here, Mom uses for the acorn to sift it and get the fine, fine acorn. In fact, there's still some on there. It's just all such fine work. This is a long process too, stitch by stitch, and people think they can buy these baskets for $20. Okay. Well, this is the part I was telling you where I'm having that problem of adding on, where this piece here shows. But you pull it all the way through down to the end there, and then poke it through the next one. And just cross over it, Mom?
Mm-hmm.
Yeehaw, no, oh, my mom was there.
Mmm, cheers.
The reason we started the language was because Mom said she wanted someone to talk to. And that was my main goal, was to be able to talk to Mom.
Actually, it's just the fluentness of Jennifer's and Dave's uncle, and he lives in Rosigen.
Yeah.
His name is Felix Icho. And Saturday's going to be his birthday, 96, huh?
Yep.
And me, I'm just learning again. So we're the only two that actually do speak our language. And he's a Wukchumni.
The language, when you understand the language, that's who you are.
Ha'ama Habita?
Ineshita.
Ineshita, yeah.
Ha'ama Ineshita.
Yeah.
Is how are you feeling? Ha'ama Ineshita Hachi, how are you feeling today?
We don't have a goodbye. Because we never said goodbye, we just said we'll see you later when you return and all that. Hadal mahuiwin. Ikat namam hadal mahuiwin. That's, I'll see you when you return. We lived over here behind Cutler Park on the next road across from the St. John's River. And we'd walk way on down, my grandma and my grandpa, and gather roots, way long roots. Now they built houses out there. No more roots. Yes, we have the preserve down here. And a lot of our white roots are growing there where our great grandmas dug a long time ago.
This land here is where our ancestors used to come and gather white root all the time. Oh, they'd bring their biscuits and their beans, sit out there and pick all day. People wanting to learn keeps me going, because otherwise I'm gonna be sitting here by myself making a basket. You know, that ain't no fun. It's more fun with everybody here and talking about stories and different things you remember when, you know, so. The white root is right out over there, look. A green bladed grass. And this grass, you have to be careful when you're getting in here, because it'll cut you. It's sharp.
This is my first time, I don't know.
You can get on the edge over there.
Okay.
There's anywhere along here, or even get in the middle, but I haven't tried it in the middle, but I think the edges are better because they're just going right out. Yeah, see, I got all these going here. So these are the weavers, and they're hard to cut, so. And see how skinny and fat it is? You want your weaver to be at least a little bit the same width all the way down to try to get the right width. What was it, in 1991, I think it was, we got permission to come out here and gather the materials. Whoever gets the longest one gets a dollar.
That's gonna be me, because mine's still going. I did that one from the beginning.
Show off. Luana. I always say, how'd those old ladies do this, man? It's hard work.
I do this once in a while.
They just crisscross every which way.
I wonder if it's connected to all these other roots.
And that's the reason it's good to get people out here to dig, because it's thinning it out also, making it the room for these other ones to grow.
Auntie.
Pretty, that's nice.
Grandma, I'm done.
Good girl. Since I got my long one. I know there's another one there though. And I think this will be a nice long white one. But there's more in there. They're just all tangled. I love it. I love digging in the dirt.
Makes me feel good. It's a sight to see for an old person. You know, we're supposed to be the caretakers of the land, and that's why we tell them they got to give thanks for what they received from the earth. You have to give back to it.
Hey, Grandma. That's how long it is.
That's a good one.
Yeah, this is little roots are getting into it. I got one!
Oh, look at that, man.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look at it. Pretty cool.
Wait, let's see.
That's okay. That's all right. We're working.
Oh!
Hey, went club clear over there, over here.
What's up?
Auntie, keep it going. Oh,
you got the longest one.
After we dig the roots out, we put the ground back in, the dirt back in where we dug it, so that it'll be make it nice and grow again, stuff all the roots and everything. So whatever we pile up, we push back in there.
And I want to keep on making baskets and teach my granddaughter and teach whoever wants to learn, because it's just pride, you know, and making things and accomplishing something.
And I'll do it till I'm an old lady and can't go gather no more.
Look at my nails. The dirtier the better, huh?
Yeah, I do. I always stick my hand out of the dirt and just start going like that.
Just gotta dig it out, yeah. Look at Mom's prize winner there. Look at her. Hanging over her shoulder. Now I can see how that would touch the ground. See, look. Oh, yeah.
Almost.
Yes, it was a nice day.